internal voltages of loaded machine under transient condition. All the preceding discussions pertains to a synchronous generator that carries no current at the time of three-phase fault occurs at the terminals of the machine. That is, you are consider unloaded generator subjected to three-phase fault. Now we'll consider a generator that is loaded when the fault occurs. For that, just I am taking a small network which is consist of a generator. It is connected through a external impedance ZE, which is connected to load. If you are modeling this particular network with its reactance diagram, that is, there is a reactance, then the source of voltage can call EG, you can call XS, and there is a external impedance, it is Z external, then it is a voltage, it is a load here, it is a load connected here. There is a load. Then the current which is delivering is IL. This is a network under healthy condition. Now I will consider the same network, having XS and it is the value what I am calling is EZ, and there is a Z external, then it is supplying to the load here. This is a load. Then it is carrying the load current of IL. Then the different voltages what I am getting here is, under healthy condition, the voltage across the terminals is VT, and the voltage, the internal voltage is EZ, and it is represented by EZ and reactance of XS and external impedance of ZE, and it is supplying the current load. Suppose there is a three-phase fault occurs on the terminals of the generator under load condition. Here there is a fault occurs, three-phase, that is loaded generator, there is a three-phase fault occurs at this point. Then the voltage, before the fault occurs, the voltage across the terminals, that is what I am calling here is, it is VF. That is, the VF is the voltage before the fault occurs at the point P. This is point P, where there is a fault occurs. Here, when there is a three-phase fault occurs, now the current, now the current is not IL, but there is the fault current which is flowing here. And at the same time, the value of XS will not XS, but in the three different periods, it may be XD dash, or it may be XD double dash, or it may be XD dash, or it may be the XD, depending upon three different regions, that is subtransient, transient, and steady state condition. Therefore, you have to model this whole network in a such a way that when the system is operating under, when there is no fault on the system, then it has to supply the current of IL, and at the same time, the network, when it is subjected to a three-phase fault, in that case, it has to supply the fault current. Such a network you have to devise from this discussion. Therefore, I am drawing a network once again, a new one. that is I am representing this with a reactance and source of voltage, and it is external impedance, then there is a load here. There is a load here. Load here. Then I am using a switch here that is under healthy condition and short circuit condition. This is switch S. When switch S is open, S is open, in that case, the current in the system is IL. The current which is flowing in the system is IL. IL is the load current. Suppose the S is closed, means it is short circuited. In that case, there is a fault current will flow. That depending upon either it may be subtransient or a transient, or it may be steady state fault current. Then once again, the conditions required are, here it is, the terminal voltage must be Vt here, and the voltage across at the fault point P, that is represented as it is Vf, that is pre-fault voltage, Vf. Okay. Now, when there is a switch is closed, the current in the circuit is, now it is If. It may be If. If in that is the case, this can be represented by, for subtransient current, if you are interested in subtransient current, it should be represented by XD double dash. This should be IF double dash. That is subtransient fault current. Then this voltage source I can represent by EG double dash. That is, you have to devise the internal voltage of the generator, that is the voltage behind the transient reactance, it is called voltage behind the transient reactance, such that is, you have to find out the value of EG double dash. That EG double dash is delivering IL when a switch is open. Then at the same time, EG dash is giving IF double dash if the S is closed, means it is the short circuit. Therefore, you have to find out the value of EG double dash. You have to find out the value of EG double dash. For that, you look into the condition. Before the short circuit occurs, that is, I'll call it as S is open. In that case, the current is IL, the voltage at this point is Vf. Okay, means when S is open, it has to supply the current IL. Then what is the pre-fault voltage? It is Vf. Then how to find out the value of EG dash? That is, we have to see here. That is, when the S is open, the current which is flowing in the system is IL. It is IL. Therefore, you can apply here, that is EG double dash is equal to, it is Vf, that is voltage here, plus it is the current is IL, and the total reactance, that is Z external plus XD double dash, that is z external plus xt double dash. That is the internal voltage of the generator. Or if you are only confined to the terminal voltage, in that case, EG double dash can be, if you are starting from here itself, that is VT plus IL XD double dash, because the terminal voltage VT plus drop in this XD double dash, that is VT plus IL into XD double dash, that gives the value of EG dash. Either you can find out from the free fault voltage VF, in that case there is an extra drop is adding, that is IL Z external. If you are adding the drop of IL XD double dash, in that case you have to add to the VT, that is EG double dash is equal to VT plus IL XD double dash, means it you are getting EG double dash. Now the same circuit I will consider for when there is a short circuit occurs. When the short circuit occurs, in that case, okay. Now the switch is closed. The switch is closed now. Now the current is IF double dash. Current is IF double dash. Means when it is short circuited, the EG double dash has to supply IF double dash. When this the switch is open, when the switch is open, it has to supply the current of IL. Okay. In this case, when it is short circuited, it has to supply the fault current of IF double dash. Then if you look into the circuit here, there is a, sorry, I will draw the diagram once again here. That is under short circuit current, what you are getting here is EG double dash, it is XT double dash, it is Z external, and it is a short circuit here, and the load is bypassed because it is a load here, because here already there is a short circuit occurs here. Therefore, the current here is IF double dash. Therefore, the IF double dash can be calculated as it is EG double dash divided by XT double dash plus Z external. That is, you have to look into this, the loop. It is a loop, the voltage is E, whereas the reactances are XT double dash plus Z external. That the XT double dash plus Z external is in the numerator. That is voltage by the impedance, that gives the current IF. That how you have to calculate the fault current. Therefore, in this discussion, the important thing is how to determine the voltage behind the transient reactance. Then if you are going for the discussion for the under transient condition, the transient condition, what we are seeing here is for subtransient condition. If you are going for the transient condition, in that case, you have to draw the circuit in a such a way that it is XT dash, then it is represented by EG dash, and it is Z external or X external, then this is the load. It is a load. In this case, once again, you are using the concept of closing the switch. When the switch is open, the current is IL. When the switch is closed, then it is supplying the transient current of IF dash. That is because it is represented for transient period. Therefore, for this, it is EG dash. If you are taking this as a preferred voltage Vf. This voltage is the terminal voltage Vt. In that case, Eg dash can be written as, with respect to preferred voltage, Vf IL plus Zxt plus Xt dash. That is Xd dash plus Z external. This is one. Or Eg dash in terms of terminal voltage, it will be Vt plus IL into Xt dash. That is, you are seeing, if you are taking this voltage, then only drop you have to add is, that is IL into Xt dash. In that case, it is IL dash. If you are starting with Vf, in that case, you have to add this drop plus you have to add the drop of the Xt dash also. Therefore, it is Xt plus Sz external. Once if you are getting this, then the under short circuit condition, the model is like this. That is, it is Eg dash. Here it is Xt dash. It is Z external. And there is a short circuit occurs here. Then the fault current is here If dash. Therefore, the If dash can be calculated as, it is Eg dash divided by Xt dash plus Z external. This is how you have to calculate the fault current for the different conditions. The same thing is explained clearly in this particular slide. We will go by step by step. That is, consider the generator that is loaded when the fault is occurs. That is, you are taken here the healthy condition. It is represented by Eg, Xs, Z external and load impedance. And we are considering the fault is occurring at point P. That is, the voltage before the fault is, it is Vf, that is called as a pre-fault voltage. And under healthy condition, the current which is delivered is IL. The current is delivered IL, and Z external is the impedance of the line which is connecting generator and the load. Now, the same model is replaced by this. Means you have to look into for two different conditions. One is under healthy condition, normal condition, and another you have to consider under fault condition. Then you have to devise the value of Eg double dash such that under normal operating condition, it has to deliver the current IL, but under short circuit condition, it has to supply the transient current depending upon either it is a transient, subtransient or steady state, I double dash. Okay. Therefore, the circuit model is represented here. I am considering for transient current. For I double dash, I am devising this particular circuit. Here, what I am doing here is the same circuit, except that the voltage which is what I am representing here is by Eg double dash. That is, I am calculating here Eg double dash. Eg double dash is the voltage behind the transient reactance such that this Eg dash will supply current IL to the load when the switch is open. At the same time, same Eg double dash will supply the fault current when the switch is closed. Okay. For that, we are writing the equation, the voltage equation here. That is, when the switch is open, then the voltage here is Vf. The voltage is Vf here. And or the voltage across the terminal is Vt and the current in the circuit is IL. You can look into here. To Vf, if you are adding the drop in the Z external and drop in the Xt dash, what you are getting is Eg dash. Therefore, I am writing Eg double dash is equal to preferred voltage Vf plus the drop across Z external and Xt double dash. therefore z external plus xt double dash. It is the one equation you are getting. Or if you are taking Vt, if you know the terminal voltage Vt, in that case Eg double dash can be calculated as Vt. You can look into here, because to Vt I am adding the drop across this reactance of Xt dash. Vt plus IL into Xt dash, Xt double dash. This also gives the Eg dash. Under short circuit condition, it is supplying a transient current I double dash. Therefore, your I double dash will be, it is Eg double dash divided by Xd double dash plus Z X. This is how we have to calculate the fault current. The same thing is explained here. That is, in the circuit B gives us desired result. That is, the circuit B gives our desired result. What is that desired result? Eg dash, Eg double dash supply current through the transient reactance, the steady current IL when the switch S is open. That is, I explained, when the switch S is open, it is supplying a current of IL. And supplies the current to the short circuit, supply the short circuit through the XD double dash and the Z external when the switch S is closed. If we can determine Eg double dash, this current through Xt double dash will be I double dash. That is, if it is short circuited here, then the current which is supplied here is I double dash. When it is open, in that case it is IL. When it is short circuited, the current will be I double dash. Therefore, what is written here is, when the switch S is open, Eg double dash is equal to Vt plus JIL Xt double dash. That is, he is adding IL Xt dash drop to the Vt, then you are getting Eg double dash. Or you can go for Vf, you have to add here IL, here it is IL, IL plus IL Z external. If you are adding to the Vf, that also yields the value of Eg double dash. That also gives the Eg double dash. The same thing is written. That is, for terminal voltage is written, Eg double dash is equal to Vt plus JIL Xt double dash. Where Eg double dash is called as subtransient internal voltage. It is called as subtransient internal voltage. If you are representing for a transient period, then it will be Eg dash, that is Vt plus JIL, then it is represented by Xt dash. The voltage Eg dash and Eg double dash and Eg dash are determined by the value of IL. Then one more important point to be noted is that Eg double dash and Eg dash are equal to the no load voltage Eg when the IL is zero, at which Eg is equal to Vt. We know that under no load condition, that is, even though you are representing with the reactance, this Eg double dash, you can call it is Eg dash. That is, here it is a terminal voltage Vt. Now here you are not connecting any load here. The switch is open, IL is zero. In that case, the terminal voltage Vt is equal to the internal voltage Eg. If there is no current is flowing here, then Eg double dash is equal to Eg dash is equal to Eg. That is only one voltage, that is the internal voltage of the generator. This is how we have to analyze the system under the load condition when it is subjected to three phase fault. Then extending the same for a synchronous motor, the equation will be changed here. EJ dash is now, it is instead of VT plus JIL XT dash, it has become VT minus IL XT double dash, that is EC double dash. Because if you are looking into the representation of a synchronous motor, the direction of the current is in this direction. That is your I double dash is like this. In that case, the terminal voltage VT, which is greater than the internal voltage, because it is applied voltage VT. Therefore, the VT can be calculated as it is EC double dash plus IL XT double dash, or EC double dash is equal to VT minus IL XT double dash. Similarly, it is holds good for the transient condition also. It is also valid for transient condition. This is how you have to determine the internal voltages of the loaded generator subjected to